Here we go. As I went a-walking one morning in May, I met a young couple so fondly did stray. One was a young maid so sweet and so fair, and the other was a soldier and a brave grenadier. And they kissed so sweet and comforting as they clung to each other. They went arm in arm along the road like sister and brother. They went arm in arm along the road till they came to a stream. And they both sat down together enough to hear the nightingale sing. Well, out of his knapsack he took a fine little fiddle, and he played a such merry tunes that the valleys did ring. He played a such merry tunes that you ever did hear. And softly cried the fair maid as the nightingale sings. And we kissed so sweet and comforting as they clung to each other. They went arm in arm along the road like sister and brother. They went arm in arm along the road till they came to a stream. And they both sat down together, love to hear the nightingale sing. Well now, says the young maid, will you marry me? Oh no, said the soldier, however can that be? For I've my own wife at home in my own country, and she is the finest little maid that you ever did see. And they kissed so sweet and comforting as they clung to each other. They went arm in arm along the road like sister and brother. They went arm in arm along the road till they came to a stream. And they both sat down together, love to hear the nightingale sing. Yeah, they both sat down together, love to hear the nightingale sing. Was down by Brannigan's corner one morning I did stray. I met a fellow rebel and to me he did say, we have orders from the captain to assemble at Dunbar, but how are we to get there without a motor car? Oh Barney dear, be off with cheer, I'll tell you what we'll do. The specials they are plentiful, but they are a few. We'll send a wire to Johnson to meet us at Stranraer. I'ma give the boys a bloody good drive in Johnson's motor car. When Dr. Johnson heard the news, he soon put on his shoes. He says this is an urgent case, there is no time to lose. He then put on his caster hat and on his breast a star. You could hear the ding going through Glenfin of Johnson's motor car. Well, when he gets to the railway bridge, the rebels he saw there. Johnson knew the game was up, for at him they did stare. He said, I have a permit to travel near and far. Ah, the hell with your English permit, we want your motor car. When they got the bell tink, when they hear the news, my car, it has been commandeered by the rebels at Dunluce. We'll give you a receipt for it, all signed by Captain Barr. And when Ireland gets her freedom, boy, you'll get your motor car. Well, they put the car in motion and they filled it to the brim with guns and bayonets shining, which made old Johnson grin. And Barney hoisted the Sinn Féin flag and it fluttered like a star. And we gave three cheers for the IRA and Johnson's motor car. Thank you so much, guys.